to sneeze.
Bless me. I think by now everyone is sort of sick of Facebook. I mean, it's been around for over 10 years. Remember when people actually posted things? For all you kids out there, people used to use that box at the top to write their status for their thoughts and feelings. How old school is that?
In fact, people used to post in each other's walls and people would post pictures of themselves when they went overseas. It was great. Okay, it was never great. It was still better than what it is now, but Facebook used to be about the people you knew. Now it's mostly ads and memes. This is Facebook as how I see it. There are the people who post nothing at all. That's most people, right? Then there's the people who post a little bit. Maybe they, you know, upload a couple photos or they tag people in memes or they comment on things. Now that's a lot of people as well. Then there's this huge gap where you have people who post a little bit and then there's people who post too much. You know those people, right? They post their thoughts, their feelings, their bowel movements. They just share that little bit too much about their lives, and they all seem to be very politically opinionated. Or they post about things like their passions. Oh, I'm gonna post my passion on Facebook or people won't know that I'm passionate about this thing that I'm passionate about. Or it's just really boring or stupid stuff like, hey, I went for lunch today with my friend. Oh, how about that Trump prick? 5G is gonna make us all sick. I really think I might save the environment today by myself. My ex is such a loser. Anyway, okay, that's not what I'm here to talk about. The reason I'm talking about Facebook is because, like I said before, it's ads and memes, right? Well, I also found another thing that seems to be very common on Facebook now. Life hacks. You know, those videos with annoying music and people doing and making useless shit. I've been doing my research and I found the worst page on Facebook. 5-minute crafts. Videos on life hacks, uninformative tutorials, and general life tips. The problem with these videos is that you watch one of them and then your whole wall is inundated with the same sort of things just over and over again. So look, I'm gonna make an investigation to see if I can utilize any of these life hacks and use them in my real life, because maybe they're not all that bad. Maybe they're actually helpful. All right, let's start with 22 ingenious hacks with Coca-Cola. Everyone seems to have Coke laying around their house, even if they don't drink it, so maybe we can use Coke for useful things. I mean, couldn't you use WD-40 or something? You know, something that's not Coke? Let's sit. Okay, let's see where this goes. Fine.
Oh yeah, this works so well. Yeah, this is great.
Do cleaning cloths not exist? Am I crazy? She has a glass Coke bottle? Was this video shot in 1950 or something? So the Coke bottle that you're gonna drink once, you're gonna apply silicone to it so you can't break it. Look, I know this is controversial, but here's a solution. Just use one of these, right? Look, I know what you're saying. A Coke bottle from the Bronze Age is definitely better for the environment. Well, you know what? Coke is bad for your body, so don't f***ing drink it. Easy. Alright, so the Coke hacks didn't really work out very well. Let's try something different. Great hacks you definitely need this summer. it's coming up to summer here, so, you know, I could definitely use some summer hacks. Too sunny. It's summer. What the f*** do you think there's going to be? Clouds.
Clouds.
Holy shit, that's not what I thought was going to happen. You couldn't just buy a golf hat or something? I see what they're doing with this. If you forget your bathers, all you need is a sewing kit, scissors, and your bathers to measure out the new bathers that you're gonna make. All right, what else do we have? Ah, incredibly helpful banana hacks. Oh, you're telling me she can't push it, but she can lift it up to put the banana peels under, so then she can push it. All right, good start. Use a cloth. Use a cloth. Okay, these are helpful. These are very helpful. If you don't have a cloth, just use a banana peel. It's fine. That'll work. Do you have to be in every one of my videos? Huh? All right. Banana peel. Seems like that's nature's remedy for everything. The banana peels. Let me guess, banana peels. You then. Alright, this one looks pretty good. It's called Be Friendly to Everyone. Ah, classic, not the hero the city wants, but the hero the city needs trope.
Him up. Did you whoop his ass? I bet you hit that motherfucker with a bat, didn't you? Cling! Bow! His ass up there. No, wait a minute. You capped him. You capped that motherfucker, didn't you? That's why you out here in the desert, ain't you?
But anyway, Mr. 20-year-old man baby saves the day.
What a pussy.
Doesn't happen, but okay. Ah, she's getting food for him. Good one, Batgirl. This girl is just full of just biggest heart. Can you feel the music? Let's get wild. We're magic, you and I. They call us reckless, but we don't mind. We Wow, Mr. Man Baby saves the day again. I'm sure they didn't want to make this video to make themselves feel better and make them think that they're good people. I'm sure they made it to make society better. Just tell her.
I don't get it.
They're trying so hard to make themselves look good that they're just doing this dumbest shit. Just tell him. Just use your words and say, hey, you might be crossing the road when you shouldn't be. You fucking idiots. If it's only for now, I don't mind. Excuse me, ma'am. Sorry for waking you up, but this gentleman right here is trying to steal your wallet. Nah, let's just stomp on her foot instead and hurt her. That's a great idea. That is the best idea. Oh look, an impossible situation that this guy saves the day to. Wow. I wish I was this guy. That's not how you steal a car. And that's not going to stop someone who's robbing a car in broad daylight. If they're willing to do that, your throwing of the bottle is not going to stop them. Oh, and they find each other at the end. How cute. Oh, wow. So it seems like this ensemble of characters seem to make ridiculous videos with each other. But I haven't even gotten to the best video yet. The creme de la creme. Excuse me. Just do your zip up and tell her that she's a fucking idiot for trying to embarrass you. It's really not that big a deal. If you put a lot of importance into something like this, then yeah, it's gonna seem like a big deal. But the less emphasis you put on it, then the less that it's gonna be a big deal to other people. You don't care, you just made a mistake. People's buttons come undone on their shirt, or the wind blows their skirts up, or something like that. Like, it's not a big deal, you just deal with it and move on. They're trying to make this a big deal to say, hey, follow these rules. Well, if someone's not following the rules, then they're just a fucking dickhead, aren't they? Look, I don't really see the big deal about this. Like, she should be able to eat whatever the fuck she wants. And if you don't like it, then don't date her. You shouldn't have to pander your diet to other people just to make them feel better. Fellas, I'm sure you've been in this one before. The simple answer to this is don't date her again if you don't like it. What if someone has a specific diet that they have to follow? You know, I would have thought that the obvious solution is to put Glad Wrap over it so the smell doesn't go everywhere. But that would be too obvious, am I right? I can't do this anymore. Look, I'm gonna make my own life hacks video, and it's gonna be 100 times better than these pieces of shit. Here is my unspoken etiquette food-related craft people hacks video for everyone to enjoy.